Hi, it's Ty, the Real Estate Guy, and today we'll be discussing things that influence how homes are priced. If this is your first time to my channel, you'll want to hit the subscribe button below to stay up to date on the latest real estate tips and trends. So let's get rolling. A lot of people I meet think that home builders are just jacking prices up willy-nilly. Sure, some home builders do increase their profit margins during hot markets, but there are actually a lot of factors that go into how a home is priced. So today, I'm gonna give you the rundown of these items. There are a lot of variables and it's not always easy to understand, but this list should give you some clarity. The first and largest determining factor is the current market conditions, especially when you consider how much market conditions affect many of the items I'm about to mention. So, in a hot market, the cost for most things increase, and in a slow market, most things decrease in price. That's a simple economics of supply and demand. Even if your local market is declining, if things are hot nationally, the cost to build will most likely continue to rise. Location. Buying a home closer to the city will almost always be more expensive. For instance, one of my bosses and I built the same floor plan with the same home builder. He built in a prestigious part of town, while I built out away from the city. He paid about $80,000 more than I did. Even crazier, he built on a half acre lot, while I built on a 2 acre lot. This leads me to the next item that can change the price of the home drastically. Lot size. Obviously, a home built on a 1 acre lot is going to be more expensive than a similar home built in the same area on a 1/6 acre lot. The price of the home site is determined not only by how much the builder pays for the land, but how much work they need to put into the land as well. There's a cost to bring sewer lines, water, and utilities to each home site. Retaining walls, fences, and things of that nature will also increase the price you pay for the home site. Staying with this subject, a more desirable home site will have an additional premium. This can be things like views, private street, waterfront, and etc. On the contrary, less desirable home sites will be less expensive. Things like the size of the home site, or if it's close to things like power lines, or a mink farm, and a canal. You know, things of that nature. You may also pay more for the home site, depending on what direction the house faces. In cold weather locations, a lot of people refuse to live in a home that faces north because the front of the home doesn't get any sun, making it near impossible for the snow to melt. On the other hand, many people want their homes to face west because in the evening, their home will shade their backyard, making it the perfect place to have a barbecue or just to hang out. The builder will reduce the premium on north-facing lots while increasing the premiums on west-facing lots to encourage the people who really don't care to select a less desirable home site. We can't forget city fees. It's not uncommon in Utah for cities to charge the home builder more than $20,000 per home site when they pick up the permit. The price for a building permit seems excessive at first glance, but these fees help with local schools, fire, police, and etc. Another thing that affects home prices is the builder's included features. Some builders hardly include anything at all, while other home builders may include loads of expensive features that are upgrades with their competition. This can be things like a grandmaster bath, 9-foot ceilings, granite countertops, and etc. Then there's the labor cost. Once again, it's a lesson in economics. When there's not enough labor to go around, the trades who are hired by the builder to do specific jobs can charge more. When the housing market slows down, these same people have to reduce what they charge in hopes the builder will hire them. In a hot market, the cost of building materials can and usually will increase. Conversely, in a slow market, the cost of materials goes down. But the number of homes the builder builds will also figure into the cost of the home because the large home builders often get better pricing on materials due to the fact that they are placing larger orders on a more consistent basis. That's why small home builders are often more expensive and don't offer as many included features. The builder also has to consider that a certain percentage of their buyers will have a realtor. The cost of this commission, based off of that guesstimated percentage of buyers that will bring an agent, is added to the price of the home. The final and maybe most obvious item I'm going to discuss is the size of the home. Clearly, the bigger the home, the bigger the cost. That's why I do my best to convince my clients to buy a home that's the right size for them, especially because most people have a budget. Buying a home that's bigger than you need and one that pushes your price point will most likely hinder your ability to have the upgrade you want in your brand spanking new home. Well, that's it. For more great new home construction videos, please hit the subscribe button below. Also, you can find me on Instagram at @TyTheRealEstateGuy. If you found this information helpful, please give me a thumbs up. And if you know someone that's looking to build a home, please share this video with them. If you have any questions or comments, I would love to hear from you. Please type your remarks below. Thanks for watching, and once again, please hit that little red subscribe button below. It'll make you feel good.